Cursor path is an indispensable feature in creating software training and simulations. It allows you to simulate mouse clicks and movements in your project. Let's watch and take advantage of this tutorial video to create your own project in an effective way. While you have to add cursor paths manually to any types of project you have created from, such as a blank project, a demonstration video, a responsive project, and a project with imported PowerPoint slides, ActivePresenter automatically inserts cursor paths to simulation recordings. When you record simulations, all mouse clicks and movements are recorded and converted into cursor paths, and then inserted to slides step by step. You can see that in this example, I recorded software simulation training with the output as a bunch of slides, in which cursor paths are automatically inserted as a part of screen recording. Let's see the demonstration preview. For more information, please refer to video, Creating Software Simulations. That's how cursor paths are automatically added when you record simulations. Now I'll show you the way to insert cursor paths manually to a project. For example, I'm going to insert an introduction slide with a cursor path to make the continuation for this project. The contents are added and the only thing left that needs to be done is inserting a cursor path. To do that, you just go to the Annotation tab and select Cursor Path. In both ways, adding cursor paths manually or automatically, you still have the opportunity to adjust their paths, effects, styles, timings and speeds. To move the cursor path to another position, select the object then drag it to the position you wish. If you want to change the start or end point of the path, first click anywhere on the canvas to deselect the path. After that, click the start point or end point and drag it. A control point which appears when you select the start point is also available for you to change the path shape. The cursor path is curved by default. You can also set it straight by right-clicking and selecting Straight Cursor Path. Sometimes, there are many clickable objects in your slide as in this example, so you may need to add mouse cursors to the path. In such case, hover anywhere over the dotted line till the pointer changes to a pencil. Then you click to add a point and drag that point to the position you want. Similarly, I'll add a mouse cursor to this button. When selecting the cursor path, the properties pane appears and allows you to customize cursor image, click point, and effect. To save time, I'll add effects to these cursor paths at the same time. Before that, holding down Ctrl while you select them. First, to change the style of a cursor, click the cursor image drop-down arrow to select your desired one. You can even use your own cursor image by clicking from projects or from file. Next, to add effects to these mouse cursors, select a desired click point from the type drop-down list. Then, further customize the click sound, time and effect if you wish. Click Apply to All to apply changes to all click points of the same type. Mouse cursors are highlighted with a yellow circle by default. You can change them the way you like. Select Show to End to show the path until the end of the slide. A cursor path is visible for the entire duration of a slide. However, you can change when its movement starts and ends. You can also speed it up or slow it down before the end of its movement. Let's take a look at the cursor path object in the timeline. The yellow diamond represents a click point. The gray vertical lines denote the start and end of a cursor path respectively. The green line indicates the moving duration of the cursor. The gap between the gray and red vertical lines is the stop duration of the cursor. You can drag the lines to change where the movements of the cursor begin and how long they last on the slide. Let's see the preview. Alternatively, you can also adjust the timing and speed of the mouse movement in the cursor section of Properties pane. The most important thing that helps your simulation project run smoothly is the continuation of cursor paths between slides. ActivePresenter records all the mouse clicks and movements, including unnecessary points as when you stop the mouse. If you want to remove these points, right-click them and select Delete. Or when you drag the start or end point of a cursor path, ActivePresenter also moves the corresponding point in the previous or next slide to ensure a smooth mouse movement. That's thanks to the cursor snapping tool in the View tab. In some cases, as when I delete the slide 4 in this example, the cursor paths can be out of sync and the mouse movements are not continuous. To avoid this, right-click the start or end point, then select Snap to Previous or Snap to Next. Finally, let's see the preview of this project. That's how to add and customize cursor paths in ActivePresenter 7. Hope it's helped. Thank you for watching.